A PRP fire captain who resigned after a child pornography investigation appeared in court this morning to answer to charges. WLKY's Lexi Sheen was there. She joins us live from the newsroom with more on what happened. Lexi.
Well, Karen, James Mason is out of jail and made his first appearance in front of the judge today after telling police last week that he, quote, simply needs help. The ex-firefighter entered a not guilty plea.
Mr. Mason, you charged three counts of possession of matter for training a sexual performance by a minor.
40-year-old James Mason faced serious charges Monday morning, the culmination of an investigation that began 6 months ago when police say one of Mason's family members was using his computer at his J-Town home and stumbled upon sexually explicit pictures of children.
The family member actually was looking for photos on his computer and found these.
That family member contacted police in June, who in turn contacted the PRP fire department. The fire captain was immediately placed on administrative leave and resigned 2 days later. Then, just last week, Mason was escorted from the Jeffersontown Police Department and taken to jail.
When you've got a situation like this that it touches home, we all have kids in our families, kids of our own, and it just, when it can really reach home or think that someone would do this and how close it is.
Mason was released from jail the day after his arrest on a $500 bond. He appeared in court accompanied by his lawyer and two family members.
We'll waive the rule, enter a plea of not guilty, pass it to January the 16th.
Both Mason and his attorney declined to talk with the media today. Police say on the day of his arrest, Mason did admit to the crimes. He's due back in court next month. Live in the newsroom, I'm Lexi Sheen, WLKY News.
Lexi, thank you. Authorities say Mason tried to destroy the evidence by damaging his computer and leaving it in a dumpster. In addition to three counts of possessing child pornography, he's also charged with tampering with physical evidence.